Okay, staying with the same team. This is my Fender Supersonic 22. It's a 22 watt combo, 1x12. It's a pretty cool little machine, plus it looks great. They did two versions of this actually, a black and silver one, kind of 70s kind of style, and the blonde and oxblood one, which is this one, which was kind of like early 60s style. I think they actually have a limited edition one of these as well, black and gold or whatever. Yeah, it's cool. It has the old kind of radio knobs and it has the 60s script logo on it, which is pretty cool. So it's a two channel amp, and the kind of power section is kind of based on the Deluxe Reverb power section. It has two 6L6 tubes in it. So your clean channel is called a vintage channel. It's kind of based on the Deluxe Reverb kind of style. Channel 2 then is called the burn channel, which is has a lot of gain on it, which is unusual for a Fender amp. As I said there last week, the bass breaker kind of took over as the more gainier amp from the Supersonic. But it's pretty cool. It actually has two gain stages. And it's got reverb, and I think I remember it was the Accutronic long tank reverb. Whatever that means, I have no idea, but that's what it, when I was looking these up, that's what was in it. So on your vintage channel, the controls there, you've got a voice switch, which is kind of normal and fat. Fat kind of just like thickens up the sound, puts a bit more bass into it. It's kind of cool if you have single coils and you want that kind of bigger kind of sound. Just the volume, treble and bass on it then. And it's kind of, you know, it's styled on 50s and 60s cleans. It's really, really nice. On the burn channel then is where the magic happens. You've got two gains. The gains are kind of separated. The gain one is kind of like for, I suppose, breakup and kind of distortion. The second gain is really for compression. Well, it adds compression and thickness and kind of sustain, I suppose. Same again, you've just got your treble, bass and middle, and you've got your volume there. That's post-gain EQ as well, obviously. And the reverb. It comes with a four button foot switch as well, where you can kind of switch between vintage and burn. You can turn on the normal fat thing as well. That it actually only works for the clean. It doesn't do anything for the distorted side. You've got your reverb and you can turn the effects loop on and off, which is kind of handy. Yeah, it's 6L6 valves, and it's got three 12AX7s in it, and I think there's two 1287s in there. And it's a Lightning Bolt Eminence speaker. The plan with this amp anyway is just to kind of have a small little pedal board to go with it. Nothing really crazy. I want to kind of keep it as the old style kind of sound, especially for the Strat. It'd be nice to just have maybe a tremolo pedal. Well, a variation on the reverb. And there's two kind of distortion pedals I'm kind of looking at. There's the Nobles ODR1, which is pretty nice on an amp like this. And the other one then is the Way Huge Green Rhino. It's a pretty cool pedal as well. It kind of gives that really cranked kind of sound, you know, that you're looking for. It's capable of way more, but both of those pedals, used kind of sparingly, will give that really nice kind of sound. And maybe just a small chorus as well. I was looking at a few pedals, but I don't want to go mad with it. It's maybe five or six pedals or whatever, just so I have that kind of style amp to kind of mess around with. So for a while I wasn't sure if I was actually going to keep this amp, but I definitely think I will. I really don't want to part with it. I hope to get to use this if I ever get back gigging. I'd definitely use this amp. If it was a case where I needed a lot more effects, if it's, you know, kind of a cover band or something like that, I'd actually use the rack switcher and have a small rack with that rack switcher and the power supply unit in it, and the floorboard from the rack. So I just kind of have maybe a couple of pedals, not on the ground, but use the rack switcher for switching them in and out, which would be kind of cool. So eventually that's what I'll kind of do and set it up with this too. So it's just nice to have those units. Anyway, that's the Fender Supersonic 22.
Bit of a toy exodus today. Just getting rid of a load of Craig's old toys, actually. Been stuck in the fucking attic for ages. So Jenny's kind of gone through a load of stuff. A couple of schools and stuff going to take, some of them, creches and things like that. Right, I can finally get in here. I must fix this guy. I think I bought him in Salou. Got broke in the luggage coming back. 6 years ago. Found my Raiders of the Lost Ark thing as well. Couldn't find a place for that. Right, hopefully we'll get in here in a little bit and get back at this. I did feck all yesterday now. Not because I felt my arm was at me or my wrist was at me, but because I was busy doing all this up in the attic. Still waiting on phone calls to confirm tomorrow. 10:40, not too bad. Right, get back to the room. Okay, just coming in here to try and do a little bit. that gear was picked up today anyway. The brother managed to pick it up, which was cool. But he was supposed to come down and visit today. But he didn't get a chance to come down, so could be next week, maybe a week after, not sure. Anyway, I'm going to try and do something here anyway. My wrist is still at me big time. Right, I may record something, I may not, I don't know. I've no idea what I'm watching. I haven't a clue. Octoman or something like that. Retro sci-fi. Got a little bit done here last night. Didn't really record anything. And I have to get back in here again later. Obviously all that rack stuff is on hold. Right. Let's get back in here in a while. Got stuff to do first. I gotta go into town. And get back in here and get some playing done before Jaden gets back. Right, just about to listen to some music and smoke a fag. Yes, I'm still smoking. I know. Trust me, it's going to change. Anyway, I just got a message. I'm just back from town, actually, by the way. I just got a message from my brother saying that him and my other brother are on the way up. So, actually, the rack gear is going to arrive here today. Deadly. Class. Right.
Cool. Talk to you tomorrow.
Really actually washing up.
This is how it's done, James.
This is how it's done, is it? So how are you? Jaden. He goes mad when he sees the camera and asks him. Look.
Jaden, look.
Jaden. No.
Yeah.
First time for everything.
What's
that got? Jesus, take it off. Let's turn this light out of here. Finally got the stuff here anyway. Plant. Alright, so finally get the chance to unbox these now and see what the story is. Can't fucking wait. Okay, audio and video rolling. Need a sync. Oh, insufficient battery and audio. Shit. Okay, just continue on. Okay, so the two brothers were down today and dropped the gear down that I was waiting for ages to get collected. It was just such an awkward position to collect them, and a bus drive wouldn't have done any of the valves in the Mesa buggy would have done any good for it, like so. Yeah, so I have that gear there now, and the first thing that's going to have to be done is I'm going to have to get a load of cables. I don't know whether to kind of make my own ones, buy a kit and make my own ones, or that'd probably be the best thing to do, really, because there's a whole fucking, you know, I need to find out where the transformers are on each unit and try and keep them all to one side, you know, or all that kind of thing. It's really awkward, like, to eliminate noise and that kind of thing. I don't want to have to buy a decimator or anything like that. Actually, I shouldn't have to now that I'm just even thinking about it right now, because they're all in loops. All the gear that I will be using will actually be in loops, and there shouldn't be a need for something like that then. I don't think there would be anyway. We'll see. I was just talking to a friend of mine online, Bats in the Bell Tower. He's fucking, if he's come across his YouTube channel, just go to it. His music's fucking amazing. Like, he just sent me a video of some rack gears that he's thinking of getting his hands on. Like, but it had the full tone. Fucking hell, the full tone 80s chorus. Man, it sounds absolutely fucking amazing. It's an expensive unit, and it's something I've come across before on YouTube, but I never kind of thought much about it. But just, it, fuck man, it knocked me for six. The video you sent me, it knocked me for six, man. Holy shit. I fucking have to get it. I have to get one. It's unbelievable, like. I think that will definitely be the next piece of gear I will probably get, will be that chorus unit, which would probably make the MP1 obsolete then for me. But I'll use it for now anyway. But Jesus Christ, I have to get one. Unbelievable. Right, I'm going to leave it at that and watch the rest of Stranger Things tonight, I think. That's about it. See you tomorrow. Charging this thing. This is what I've been recording audio with for some of the other recordings. Whenever I think of it, ran out of power last night, you would have heard. 9:29. Right. Just done a bit of tidying. I have to head in here at some point today. Yeah, so all the gear is there. Thank fuck. So it's a matter now of just figuring out what types of cables I need to kind of hook it all together, plus I need to buy a new rack case as well, which is a pain in the hole. But yeah, it'll be a good few weeks before I can really sit down and tackle that system now, so, you know, I'll just kind of incorporate little parts at a time. I might mess around with the TC Electronic later, probably through the bass breaker. I don't know, we'll see. Yeah, so it'll be a while before I can get that sorted. But yeah, I think I definitely will do a whole series of videos on it as well. Definitely will help some people. Well, if it can be found, I'm sure YouTube, there's probably hundreds of videos on it. You can't even fucking find them on YouTube. It's a joke. Okay, right, talk to you in a while. Just spending a few minutes going through the TC Electronic manual. It's the small things. Okay, we're at the end of week 45, and as of today, I still even haven't put week 44 up yet. There was a mix between so little footage and a number of other factors anyway. Still having problems with my wrist. It's kind of sore.
it's kind of limiting on what some of the licks that I'm doing, because it's a lot bigger stretches. I'm still not warming up properly, you know, that's what the problem is. I could be working on other things, but there's been so much going on over the last 2 weeks that it's hard to get in here at all. But I haven't not done anything, you know, so there's still stuff going. There's still a lot of stuff going on. Anyway, yeah, that's more or less been it. The temperature in this room has been a problem as well, especially this week. It's ice cold in here, and I mean ice cold. Like, my hands are fucking freezing now when I'm after playing a little bit tonight. And, you know, it's not doing anything any good. It just feels like my hands are kind of seizing up. They're that cold. Anyway, we're not going to make excuses about that. I suppose I could if I wanted to. Anyway, plan is over the next couple of days, get the next two vlogs up, and hopefully get them out of the way so I can concentrate on this week. So hopefully get that done in the next 2 days. So yeah, that's about it. And should we leave it at that for next week?